As water purifies your skin, so the breath is capable of cleaning and cleansing your whole being. You can take a blanket or a yoga mat and lie on your back. This session will encourage the contact between you and the natural breath. A contact that in itself sounds very easy, and when it happens, it's a small miracle. So I will encourage you to feel deeply the contact between your back and the floor, and feel how the presence of gravity, the presence of the earth, keeps encouraging the back of your body to sink into the earth, to welcome the pull that comes from the earth. There is a wish, a deep wish inside your body, all the time asking for a contact. A deep contact with the earth. And when the body receives the permission to be close to the earth, there is a deep relief and a sense of coming home, of being home, that permeates the whole body. So just let the floor touch the back of your skull. Let the floor touch the back of your right shoulder blade, right arm and right hand. Let the floor touch the back of your left arm, left hand. Allow the earth and the floor to touch the back of your rib cage, the back of your waistline, the back of your pelvis, and allow the earth to attract and invite roots to be born under your right foot and under your left foot. Feel how the contact between the earth and the back of your body creates an expansion, a widening, a softening. So feel how the back of the head opens up in a little smile. Feel how the back of the rib cage widens and softens and opens up in a smile. And feel how the back of the navel and the back of the pelvis respond to gravity by widening, softening, and finally dropping into the earth. Feel also that the contact between the earth and the sole of your feet creates another small miracle. It's like, it feels like the center of the foot slowly, gently opens up. And you can also feel sometimes that the center of the foot turns into a flower, slowly unfolding its petals. And then it's time to look inside. And as you look to the inside of your body, you can feel the space inside the skull. Let's just forget about all the things you know about the inside of the skull. Just replace whatever you know it's there with space. So that there is space inside the head, space inside the neck, space inside the right arm and the right hand, space inside the left arm and the left hand. an incredibly beautiful space inside the rib cage, and lots of space inside the pelvis. I feel that the pelvis, it's like an ancient recipient, an ancient container with space inside. And feel also that there is space inside the right leg and the right foot, the left leg and the left foot. And then very gently and very slowly you can lengthen the right leg on the floor, very slowly, like the body is moving into a different dimension, a dimension where slowness and silence is very important, is very soothing, it's very welcoming. So slowly, slowly extend the right leg, and then slowly, slowly you can extend the left leg. Unless you know that your pelvis would tilt, and then in that case you can keep the legs bent for all the length of the session. So now, as you look inside again to the body, you are very attracted by the passages that connects, for example, the inside of the skull to the neck. This beautiful passage that allows your awareness to move from the inside of the skull to the inside of the neck. And then through another passage that opens up as your awareness streams down, you move into the big lovely space which is called the house of the lungs. But you notice that to the right side there is an entry, a passage, a corridor that will take you from the rib cage into the right arm and through the right elbow down towards the right wrist, and through the right wrist into the right hand, where your awareness can spread to the tips of your fingers. And as you move back into the house of the lungs and of the heart, you feel that there is another entry that will take you from the house of the lungs into the left arm. And the journey is a beautiful journey from the inside of the left armpit down towards the elbow, and through the elbow down towards the wrist, until your awareness is able to expand into the left hand and reaches the tips of the fingers of your left hand. And as you move back to the trunk, the journey goes on down, and it will take you down into the pelvis, and you will explore the width of the pelvis, the depth, the inside space. And as you explore more and more with your awareness the inside space of the pelvis, you notice that there is a channel, a corridor through the right groin that will lead you and take you and guide you through the inside of the right thigh, inside of the right knee, down the inside of the right calf, through the beautiful passage that we call ankle, and through that passage into the right foot, where again your awareness is expanding until it touches the tips of the toes. And as you move back into the pelvis, there is this passage, this amazing corridor that allows you to enter into the left thigh. Slide down the left thigh towards the inside of the left knee and down through the left knee, down and through the inside of the left calf to this beautiful bracelet or passage or gallery that is our left ankle, until the awareness can expand, happily expand into the left foot, widening, releasing, letting it drop into the floor so that both feet are happily grounded. And then as the space inside has been polished by your awareness, by your light attention, you can let the breath, according to your own rhythm, and without making any effort and without creating any struggle, you'll just let the out-breath move through all these inner spaces like a wave that can clean and deeply purify the inside of your being. So in your own rhythm, without making or creating any conflict or any effort, just allow your next exhalation to slide, to tumble, to run like a river, like the flow of a river, all the way down your being, into the arms, into the trunk, into the legs, towards the feet, and feel how this wave is removing, is carrying all the sediments, all the unnecessary loads, heaviness, dullness that very often we tend to keep inside. Almost we get fond of them. But with the exhalation, we have this amazing opportunity of letting the sediments, the ashes, the heaviness be removed by the breath. So after the first journey with the exhalation, see if it's possible to get in contact with the pause that takes place at the end of the out-breath, which is a natural pause where the ripples created by the exhalation seem to travel further and further and further away from you and into the earth. And after that, just allow your whole body to welcome the new breath. So keep feeling that the earth acts and works like a huge magnet under your body. And in this way, the earth takes away from your body all the tiredness, the knots, the obstacles, And the breath, you can visualize the breath as this amazing wave that travels all the way down towards your feet, cleaning, dusting, polishing. It moves out from the sole of your feet. It leaves your body into the ground. It leaves your body more rooted, closer to the earth. There is a natural pause that it's beautiful to explore, and then your whole being opens up to receive the in-breath. So in your own timing, without pushing, just see if you can let your breath be turned into an amazing, purifying wave that travels through the space, through the inner space, and at the very end of the exhalation, you touch the sole of your feet. The feet relax, the body becomes heavier, and then, and only then, the whole being opens up to receive the in-breath. So a rhythm that takes the shape of a wave that polishes and cleans the inside of your being, a natural pause that follows can give you all the beautiful properties and nourishment of the new breath. And feel that the task is only to look at the breath and allow the breath to travel the whole length of your body. And when it touches the sole of your feet, the task is over. Everything that happens after the end of the exhalation is very natural, very lovely. So just enjoy the journey of the breath, and you look at it like under a magnifying glass. As the breath touches the sole of your feet, the task is over. You rest happily into the floor, and you let the in-breath move in. And very slowly you can lift the right foot from the floor, bend the knee and bring the foot close to the buttocks, not too close, but just bend it and place it again on the floor. And very slowly do the same thing with the left leg. And then you can roll on your left side. The the knees together, and maybe you can place the two hands together, one on top of the other. If that is uncomfortable, you can place one hand under the head to support the head if the head is in pain. And feel again the presence of the earth. Feel that you can let go of the whole weight of your body into the floor. Feel that the best discoveries are always done when the whole body is relaxed and there is a deep silence within and space.